That's 200 watts.
Just cruise now.
Just cruise now. How many of you guys have been in that place?
Erg mode, right? It's like Smart Trainer's dirty little secret that no one is talking about. Well, that changes today. Guys, I want to come at this from the angle of what to expect from erg mode, because so many of us get on a Smart Trainer, we start riding this thing, we're told that this is the future, this is what we should be doing, and all of a sudden we're pedaling through mud and we can't move. So what I want to do is give you my experience so far of it, what to expect from it, what to expect to feel from it, and also bring in some of the guys in the team who do use erg mode specifically for some of their own training and how they do that. I'm not going to drop massively into the specifications of erg mode and how it sort of mechanically works,
but essentially it's one of two modes that most smart trainers will operate in.
Okay, what is erg mode? Well, a quick Google search of it tells you that it's going to hold you to a consistent resistance or a constant power, which is kind of where the confusion begins, because in my mind, holding you to a consistent power or consistent resistance was like an image of a really steady 5% gradient up a hill. That is not what erg mode is. So trying to describe this to people who have not used it. Okay, so obviously there's this 360 degree of resistance. You feel it on the way up, you feel it on the way down, you feel it everywhere. But it's more than that. Okay, this is what I find so hard to get my head around. When you're in an effort, when you're, you know, you're doing hard effort, you're so used to on the road, if you back off, it's like you get a little rest. Let's say you go around a corner, you know, you bunny hop something like that. You get a little rest period and then you can go again. Here, if you back off, it throws more resistance at you. It's like this tidal wave of resistance that's building on you. And for the uninitiated, you just feel like you're pedaling in mud. I can't tell you how wrong my expectations were of what erg mode was, to the point when I was in that 200 watt death spiral of cadence, which, God, I hope you all have been in, because I really feel stupid sitting here and going on about it if you haven't been. But I genuinely thought my trainer was broken. Like, I'm sitting there going, well, this sucks. Like, what have I done here? The only reason that I didn't send this back is, well, because this was Jay's trainer that he friggin' won Zwift on. So I'm like, well, okay, it's not the trainer, it's clearly my legs.
You have to increase your power, increase your output to actually get the respite. It's almost as though you're getting ahead of the resistance. You can feel it. The moment it senses weakness, boom, a little bit more resistance. And it's like you panic.
I kept thinking it was just gonna be this constant boom, 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 and I'd switch off and it was gonna be happy days. That's not what erg mode is. It's like, it's a battle, it's a fight. It is a constant fight to hold resistance, stay in front of resistance. You know what I mean? I'm just, yeah.
What a lot of people do to overcome this is cadence, because cadence almost hides the resistance. If you can keep the free wheel spinning, it doesn't almost have time to throw resistance at you. Yeah, you're putting out the power, but you're staying ahead of that resistance. The moment it senses your cadence drops, whack, resistance, and don't even think about getting out of the saddle. That ends very badly.
A couple of don'ts. Don't change gear. Don't change gear. In fact, what you want to do is choose a gear in the very beginning, probably big ring, kind of midway up the block. That seems to be what people suggest is a good place to start. It seems to be a better way to actually produce power that the trainer likes, and you just stay in that gear. Now, what about getting out of the saddle? Well, you kind of got to, like, you can't just grind forever. Again, it's this thing of trying to get on top of the gear. So if you're going to get out of the saddle, you almost want to give it a little surge before you get out to build up your speed, to give you that split second before you see how it's not consistent resistance. Anyway, you know what I mean? And then to get back in the saddle, this is the really hard one. So again, you want to give it a little squeeze, then get in the saddle so you've got a little bit of momentum carrying through. Otherwise, I guarantee you, you will be in the death spiral of 4 RPM.
I found myself riding in positions on the bike I don't ride on the road. Like, for example, like down here, like way over the front, like trying all kinds of things to free up my legs, because this resistance is just so constant at you. It's like, it's great, but don't get me wrong, certainly good training, but I can't do it. So I'm trying to find other places on the bike to sit for moments, to give myself a rest, but not actually give myself a rest.
Right, so I've completely squashed your hopes, dreams, and expectations for erg mode, have I? You're never gonna use it? No, look, there's definitely some uses to it, and there are some ways to, well, kind of make it better, almost. So I'm using Full Gas, which is the virtual sort of smart trainer experience that I particularly use. I like the immersive nature of it. Now, in its particular settings, and I know this is kind of consistent across a lot of these sort of apps, is it has a speed of resistance. So really what that does is it changes the speed at which the trainer will adapt its resistance. Put really simply, if you were to do 400 watts, you can make it faster or slower for the trainer to react to you having to do 400 watts. And that's consistent. That's not just straight from the beginning. So like how long it gives you to get to 400 watts. It's like if you're there and you drop below, you can change how quickly it wants you to come back. And that makes a big difference.
So what Full Gas does, it gives you the option of erg mode here. So you can set your FTP, all the rest of it, and it'll work that in. But it also gives you the option, and this is where it comes into its own, of the simulation mode, which is what gives you the sense of riding on the road.
So this is a question I've asked all the guys on the team. Do you use erg mode? How do you use erg mode, etc., etc.? And I was really hoping this is going to be this constant answer that I could just come in front of you guys and say, well, the trick to this is this because that's what you use it for. No, everyone uses it completely differently. Some guys are like, I can only do longer efforts on it. It has to be like 20, 40, even an hour. I can do those sort of efforts on it. That's what I can do. Other guys, short efforts. I can only be like 30 seconds, 40 seconds. Some guys, I only ever use it for endurance. Like I just sit at an endurance pace and sit in that. I even spoke to Jay about it the other day, expecting some sort of like in-depth kind of use of erg mode. He didn't use it, doesn't really use it. Used it in the beginning when he started using smart trainers, but doesn't really use it anymore.
No two ways about it. I can definitely see how people who get used to riding erg mode get super strong, don't get me wrong, but certainly then have a style of pedaling.
The only consistent thing that all the guys, and actually Jay said as well, was that they could never do the same power they would do in a normal mode on the train or out on the road in erg mode. Okay, so that is my first Chris's experience so far of riding smart trainers vlog, a rant about erg mode. Now, I'd love to hand it over to you guys. Look, yes, some thoughts on how to use it, but I'd like some reassurance that I was not the only idiot that got on a smart trainer the first time, found themselves pedaling in mud, and subsequently wanted to throw the damn thing through the window. Please do. Next up, I want to talk a little bit about Full Gas. I want to talk about it against some of the other platforms that are out there, and yeah, how I'm maybe using it as a trainer experience in comparison to what some of the other guys are doing using it. Because you got to remember, for me, and I'm sure this is like for a lot of you, I've never done like training efforts on trainers. Like this is a totally new thing for me. And it's challenging. It's really hard. I'm struggling with it, actually. It's probably why I'm sitting here and complaining about it. But it is difficult. I'm not going to lie to you. Everything's difficult about it. The atmosphere of it, the experience of it. Yeah, I'm finding it difficult. I'm not going to lie. Anyway, guys, I really hope you enjoyed that. Please do hit the thumbs up on the video. I really appreciate you guys doing that recently. We've got over 20,000 subs. That's cool, isn't it? That's really cool, actually. And we will see you in the very near future at a very consistent 270 watts at 88 RPM. And in other exciting news, I'm getting my second COVID shot today, so I will be fully vaccinated. See what I did there? Which is super exciting, actually. Didn't think I'd say that 12 months ago. Being vaccinated against something was super exciting, but it is. And yeah, I suppose hopefully shows that things are progressing a little bit.
So just sort of let you know, 24 hours later, yeah, not feeling amazing. Fever, real sore, fatigued, headache, a bit of a sore throat, and interesting, heart rate. Resting heart rate's up about 10 beats, which, yeah, interesting. So that's exactly 24 hours later now.
Okay, what are we? 31 hours later. Great, feel really good. And kind of still sore a little bit in the arm, but the fatigue, headache's gone, took some Panadols. And yeah, no, feeling really good. So just wanted to kind of complete that circle. That was my second shot, which they kind of say is normally the harder one. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. We will see you very, very soon. Make sure you do hit the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. We have, yeah, busy couple of months coming up.